to share this word with you this morning here. Wow, yesterday was a tough day, guys. Seeing the tragedy, the horrible evil that took place in that church in Texas yesterday, my heart has been heavy, and obviously mourning and grieving for those affected. Just devastating. I can only imagine what they're going through right now. But the least we can do is pray for them, and that's what I have been doing. I encourage you to do the same. Anyway, made me think a lot last night in my quiet time with the Lord, and led me to this very familiar passage in the back of the book, in the Revelation here. And it's a wonderful, wonderful promise that we have to look forward to as followers of Christ. It is a conditional promise. Let me read it, and I'm going to share some wisdom on it. And it comes in Revelation 21, and it's talking about making all things new. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the old heaven and the old earth had disappeared, and the sea was also gone. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, like a bride beautifully dressed for her husband. I heard a loud shout from the throne saying, "Look, God's home is now among his people, and he will live with them, and they will be his people. God himself will be with them." And then this verse, in verse 4, this is the one I really want you to focus on, and that we could hold our head up high for this, that someday he will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and there will be no more death, or sorrow, or crying, or pain. All these things will be gone forever. Wow. Guys, when we go through, when we see something like this, this is what we have to hold our hat on and look forward to, is eternity, when this will happen. I mean, there will be no more evil. There will be no more sadness, pain, suffering, death. It'll be all gone. We live in a broken world. It's a fallen world. And no one, not one of us, is exempt from the difficulties, tragedies, and the evil that stalk the path of every person that is born into this fallen race. But here in this passage, God has given us a tiny glimpse into eternity, ages to come after his final judgment, when the old order is done away with and God establishes a new heaven and earth under his perfect law. This there will be a day when all wrongs are put to right. Joy will be replaced with will replace sorrow, and God himself will wipe away every tear from your eye. You know, he wrote this final chapter to redeem mankind for all followers of Christ, and it's about true fulfillment and eternal joy. And again, there will be no more death, no sorrow, no crying, no pain, no suffering, no evil. That is something to look forward to. But like I said, this promise is only for those who have accepted Jesus as their Lord and Savior. Have you made that decision yet? I want to get real with you guys. I want to get authentic as I can. I got to speak the truth in love here. I love you all too much not to share this truth here. You know, guys, and I heard this message this weekend, and he said that there are only two eternal addresses, heaven and hell. And guys, we have to make a choice on which one will be ours. None of us are accepted into heaven by going to church, by tithing, by giving to the poor, by trying to do good works. None of us will make it to heaven, guys. You won't get to heaven by being baptized as a baby or taking sacraments. You won't get there. I'm going to stop speaking truth with you guys. And the truth is all in this book. It's not me saying these things. Pick it up and read it, and you'll find this truth. It took me many years to find this truth. Unfortunately, not everyone's going to choose heaven. It's sad. It's heartbreaking. But it's true. And I just got to share this with you guys. I want you to all to have this promise that someday, and this is just a glimpse of what we'll see in heaven. I mean, as God is speaking here, you know, through John, and that he will say that he will wipe away all these tears. There's going to be no more sorrow, no more pain, no more evil, no more death. But you have to accept Jesus into your heart by faith and His grace to receive this promise. And please, please, please don't wait another day, guys. None of us are guaranteed tomorrow. The Bible says today is the day of salvation. So please, there's no special prayer that you have to pray. The Bible says that if you confess with your mouth and you believe in your heart that Jesus died for you, you will be saved. And the Bible also says if you call His name, you will be saved. And the Bible says that He is the way, the truth, and the life, and nobody gets to the Father but through Jesus. Please, I'm pleading with you. I love you too much. I don't want to see anyone perish and spend eternity in the lake of fire, as the Bible says in a few verses before this, during the final judgment. You know, it speaks, it says, the sea gave up its dead, and the dead and the grave gave up the dead, and they were all judged according to their deeds. Then death and the grave were thrown into the lake of fire. The lake of fire is the second death. And anyone whose name was not found recorded in the book of life was thrown into the lake of fire. Guys, I don't want to see you. I don't want anyone. I love every single person, even someone who hates me. I love them, and I don't want to see them go to hell. And I'm just being real and authentic with you. You see how life could be gone like that. I mean, these people that went to church never in their wildest dreams imagined that they would take their last breath in that church because of some evil man coming in and shooting up the place. So none of us are guaranteed. That's why we need to make that decision right now, guys. Don't wait another moment. Just repent of your sins. It's very simple. It's not something you have to do every single day. Say this prayer. Just repent of your sins. Accept Him, His forgiveness, into your heart by faith in His grace, as Ephesians 2:8-9 says. And you will be saved. And you will have your eternity secured, as this passage says. And you will have that wonderful promise that there will be no more tears. There will be no more sadness. There will be no more sorrow. There will be no more death or evil. You have that promise, guys. All you have to do is make that decision. Please don't wait another moment. If you need any help with this, please reach out to me. I love you so much. I just love you so much. I don't want to see anyone take their last breath without having Jesus in their heart. So I hope this message really spoke to you today and ministered to you. If you're questioning, if you know your eternity or not, please reach out to me again. I'm here to help you and help you know that you could have a secure address in heaven. It's a very simple thing, guys, and you could follow Jesus, and He has a plan and purpose for your life that will blow your mind while you're even here in this fallen world. Yes, we all have a plan and purpose, and He wants to fulfill that plan. He wants us to fulfill that plan and purpose. But the first decision we have to make is accept Him into our heart by faith and His grace. So, again, I love you guys, and know that I'm praying for you, and have an awesome day.